Good morning, everyone. Continuing here in the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch, in the laws of Kedushas HaShabbos, the sanctity of Shabbos and the preparation of Shabbos, and today's perfect halachos for Erev Shabbos, really, lemaisa, how to get ready. And he says, mitzvah al kol adam, lirchais b'chol Erev Shabbos. There's a mitzvah upon every person, man, woman, and even children that are to the age of understanding the importance of getting ready for Shabbos, let's say 7, 8, 9, 10 years old. Lirchais b'chol Erev Shabbos, they should wash themselves every Erev Shabbos Friday. Pana v'yada v'ragla b'chamin, at least they should wash their face, hands, and their feet with hot water. Vim efshar, and if it's possible, yirchais kol gufa b'chamin, they should wash their entire body in hot water. A person should be clean. They should be ready to go to greet the Shabbos queen on Shabbos. So here he writes from the Mishnah Berurah that if a person knows that Friday afternoon is going to be a crunch time, they're working all day long, whatever it might be, it's going to be very hard for them to get ready. Even already on Thursday, they would be able to wash, and that would be considered in honor of Shabbos. Or if a person has to go to work and they're going to be working all day long, let them take a shower in the morning on Friday, and that will count for their washing for Shabbos. V'yipal az atzma b'mikveh. He writes also that a man should have the custom of going to the mikveh on Erev Shabbos on Friday afternoon, Friday morning, Friday afternoon. Why? Because that is a tahara, that is a purification that a person is making of himself. He's cleansing himself from all of the week, from all the stresses, from all the work, from all of the impurities that took place throughout the week, and he's purifying himself to get himself ready to accept the beautiful gift of Shabbos. Further, Aser Lirchaitz Im Aviv, a person, when he goes to the bathhouse, we're talking about a man over here, and he goes to the mikvah, he's not allowed to go with his father, the Chamiv, or his father-in-law, Ubal Imoy, or his mother's husband, meaning that if his mother got remarried, he can't go with the mother's husband. Ubala chaysa, nor should he go with his sister's husband. However, if the custom in that particular mikvah or bathhouse is that the men cover their nakedness, meaning they're not completely exposed and revealed, then mutter, then it would be permissible. But if not, then it would not be permissible to go with these people. V'chein ha-talmid lo yirchaitz im rav, so too a student should not be in the mikveh together with his teacher, his rebbe, the one who teaches him Torah. V'im rav b'tzarech lo, however, if his rebbe, let's say, is older, and he needs his student, she'esham shenu, to take care of him, mutter, then it would be permissible. And the last halacha over here of getting ready on Friday afternoon, there is a mitzvah to scrub one's hair, meaning to wash their hair, soap and water, make themselves squeaky clean, and also to cut their nails. And if their hair grew and it was unkept and a little bit long, they should also get a haircut in honor of the Shabbos. Now he's talking about mystical ideas over here, that a person should not cut their fingernails and their toenails on the same day. And there's another opinion also, which is from the Sefer Chassidim, that says that even on Rosh Chodesh, a person should not cut their nails, and they should not cut their hair either. Even if Rosh Chodesh falls out on Friday, which normally you're doing it to get ready for Shabbos, if you hold of the opinion of the Sefer Chassidim, then you would not cut your hair or your nails on that Friday, which is Rosh Chodesh. This is not a custom that is necessarily universally accepted. There are many people that do keep the words of the Sefer Chassidim, but there are many, many droves of people that do not. So each one according to what their custom is. Yesh machpidin. There are those that are careful. Shelo litol esad ziponim kesidron. They don't cut their nails in order, in sequence, going from one finger to the next. Rather, ela bediluk, they skip fingers. Again, these are all Kabbalistic, mystical reasons. Dahaynu biyamin, when it comes to their right hand, maschilim be'esva asamech la'agudu, they start with their index finger, and they start with their index finger, and then they skip the middle finger, and they go to the ring finger, and then from the ring finger they go to the thumb, and from the thumb they go to the middle finger, and then finally they get to their pinky to the little finger, and by simin ba bedaga, and the way in which you can remember this is Beis Dalet Aleph Gimel Hey Bedaga. Beis is your second finger, Dalet is your fourth finger, Aleph is your first finger, your thumb, Gimel is your middle finger, and Hey is the last finger. Ubismail, what about on the left hand? Maschilim Biesba Revi. You start with the ring finger over there, and then from there you go to the index, and then you go to the little one, and then you go to the middle one, and then you go to the thumb. Ha-simin, the way to remember this with the letters is divhege. Dalet for the ring finger, beis is for the index finger, hey is for the pinky, gimel is for the middle finger, and aleph is for the thumb. Gam yesh makpidin shlalitla tziponan biyom hey. There are those who are very particular not to cut their nails on Thursday. Why? Ki maschilin ligdol biyom Shabbos, because the way that it works is when you cut something, so 3 days afterwards is when it's going to begin growing. And over here, if you cut it on Thursday, Friday, Shabbos is the third day, and that means that you cut with, and you made it in such a way that it's going to grow on Shabbos. And with something to grow on Shabbos, it's not appropriate in the honor of Shabbos to do such a thing. So the Mishnah Brewer, he recommends cut your toenails on Thursday, even though it's going to grow, but when else are you going to cut them? And you cut your fingernails on Erev Shabbos, and that means your fingernails will not be growing on Shabbos. And lastly, he says, Toiv lizoher lisoiv es hatziponayim. It's good for a person to burn their fingernails afterwards, because the Gemara tells us that if a person throws their fingernails into a public place, so, and a woman that is pregnant steps on those fingernails, there is likely that she will miscarry, she'll have a miscarriage, Rachman al-Tzad, as a result of that, and therefore a person should do whatever he can to avoid bringing michshel, bringing stumbling blocks to others. So either you should burn them, we also flush them down the toilet. The bottom line is they should be removed so that they don't end up on the floor. Okay, and last but not least, as we remember from what we saw above, when a person cuts their fingernails, they need to wash their hands afterwards. Have a wonderful, wonderful Shabbos. Look forward to learning next week.